Hi, this is Teacher Katrina and welcome back to my channel. If you want to learn more about teaching English online or starting your online teaching business, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss out on anything. In today's video, we want to talk about Manycam and how we can use Manycam for online English teaching. I think it's especially helpful for online ESL teachers to have Manycam. Just especially if you are a lazy teacher like me and you don't want to have 1,000 props. I still have a lot of props that I've collected over time, but I don't like to have to, you know, plan my lessons or think about my lessons and find props as well. So you can use both. You can use props and you can use Manycam, or you can just use Manycam. So currently I just use Manycam for my classes. I rarely use props. I have some props that are easy to pick up, like a microphone, or what else, a teddy bear or a whiteboard, pens, things that I need quickly. I have all of those things beside me. But they're the major main props that I would use, and then everything else I use from Manycam. So let's take a look at Manycam and how we can use it for online teaching. If you are interested in using Manycam in your online classes, you can download it for free. I have the link in the description. And if you want, you can upgrade for more features and to remove the watermark. But the free version is enough for you to really get to know Manycam and if it can work for you. I would recommend that if you are trying to integrate this with some online teaching platforms, you might want to ask the IT to help you set it up, make sure that it's running correctly. When you're clicking the settings on your online teaching platform, the settings for you set it to Manycam webcam as your webcam. So that will be a little bit different. So you might have to adjust the settings in the online setup. And if you can't do this, you might need IT to help you, or IT to help, tell you if it's running okay, etc. I'm currently in my Manycam standard lifetime version. So I bought the lifetime version just because it's so helpful for classes. You've no idea. It really does save you from having to plan all these different props all the time. The first thing you can do here is you can set your FPS frames per second. For me, I found that 25 frames per second was best. And sometimes if my laptop, which is just ASUS 8GB RAM, Core i5, I don't know, technology, is not like amazing. It's good for daily tasks. That's what my laptop is considered good for. I really, really like it though. It kind of looks like it has the same feel as a MacBook, but it's not as expensive. And I actually really like how to use it. So you can choose your quality. I'll just show you my 720 quality and just see if there's much difference in that. Like, personally, I don't see much difference. This is it at 720p. So I have my webcam connected. All you have to do is plug in your webcam, if you have an external webcam, and connect that. So this is the 720p, and this is the 1080p. Tell me if there's a difference. I'm not that sure. There probably is a slight difference. But if my classes are slowing, or if I feel like my laptop is slowing down, I would change it to 720. I always keep this at 25 FPS. That just suits my laptop the best, but it may be different for your laptop. So I suggest you to play around with this to find out what your laptop can handle. If you have a computer, it's probably even better. You probably have, you know, better gigabytes of RAM and whatever. Then also, here are some of the things you can do. So you can zoom in. That's it's not a good idea for me. And you can also color adjust, so you can change the color. I actually make it darker sometimes because I'm so pale when I'm not wearing makeup. So then the light is coming in on my face from the window, and I just have to, I don't know if this really fixes it, but it helps somewhat. As you can see, I just have it, I've actually didn't realize, but I always have it this way. Then you have all of these you can adjust. So we can adjust this, we can adjust this. I'm gonna put this back before I forget. I actually forget to adjust these things. Oh my god. So all of these things you might like to adjust. It's a disco here today. Okay, we'll go back to zero. It's going to take some time. I might pause this video and go to zero for all of them. Okay, that's that done. Let's go on to the crop tool. Here we can crop the video. So let the camera where you can see me. So for example, if I didn't want something, if there was something over this side and I didn't want anyone to see it, I can crop it. So it's nice if your classroom is just, if you just want this much of you visible, you can do that here and click crop. This is the cropped version and you can use 720. Does it fill out then fully? No. So you just want to play around with it and see what works best for you. I'm going to go back now to my original size. Apply crop. I don't want to crop. And then I will show you the other things you can use. So here are the effects you can add. Take a look. Here is animals. Filters, what is that? We have face accessories, they're quite popular. You can just add different things here and it's very funny. They think this is hilarious. The kids, obviously not me. And yeah, so there's a lot of different things you can do here, but they're never ending and you can download more. So you can download all or you can get more. So this is quite fun. They enjoy having all of these different these different effects, face accessories, sports. So if you're trying to explain different concepts, this is what I like to do. I like being able to explain things through pictures. I just think that it's an easier way for kids to learn. And also here is where I actually add things from. I have really random things, but I'm trying to explain concepts. So this is what scales look like, or an anaconda. I have some more advanced students and there's a lot of different things that you can add. I don't know why I have her there. But yeah, you can add more effects by clicking this button and then you can download something. You can also, let's say I want to go into the objects here and I have bowling balls. Okay. But I'm trying to explain what bowling is, but this is before the lesson begins. I'm looking at the lesson and I see this and I want it fast. What you can do is before the lesson, you have the bowling pin, so you can hide it here. So you can hide it here and then you can unhide it when that part of the lesson comes up. You can also add it to your favorites so that you have access to it, quick access to it. Your favorites tab is up here. Okay, I don't know why these are my favorites. And then, yes, so that is basically it. Okay, and what else can you do? They like this one. These are the distortions. Oh my goodness. And maybe I take this out, and these, they're just hilarious to them. Now, if you don't, if you want to share the fun and you don't want to be the only person having fun on screen, maybe you want the kids to have fun too, you can share a custom area on your screen. So you right click and then you click custom area. Custom area. So now what you can do is, I'm going to go back from this. I have my person here. So let's say this is the girl, she's in our camera. I'm not sure if you can see this, but we can zoom in on the person on the screen. So let's say, usually we have more space than this. Her camera is usually not this big. Let's say the girl is over here and you want to zoom in on her, then you can add some effects on her. So let's see, we've got, maybe you want to give her a heart. Here is a heart, and then she can see that that's visible on her screen. Or maybe you want to give her a thumbs up for doing a good job or something like this. So then you can use this to let them have some fun. You could also use the distortions. You can do from here. So this is funny. She can have a laugh. She can, or maybe you want to try some other distortions here, and she can move around. She'll probably start moving. Ha 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 ha. And then it just looks like this. And then she's like, wow. And then she probably will hide. So back to my camera again. We're back. Back to my camera again. Then the other things that I use this for is giving them rewards. Now, as you can see, every time they do a good job, I usually give them a reward and I say, oh, what color star do you want? I have regular students. I have the same students all the time. So after a while, that can get quite repetitive and boring, and they find a way to make it more interesting. So they may ask you for maybe a pig or a cat or a something else. So they really like anything that moves. So I end up giving them all kinds of things. And yeah, that that's an important part of my reward system. You can have so many different kinds of rewards. Let me see. Here is a blank page. You know, you can change the color if you want. Let's say they really like blue. Here is blue. And then you can add, what do they like? So maybe they like, okay, maybe they just want stars today, and here's a blue star, or here's a yellow star, or you could do, maybe they want to build a snowman or something. So we have snowman. I have all the parts. Maybe if they want to name the parts of the body, so maybe they want the they want the head, or they want the feet, or they want the tummy, if you want to call it that, or they want, you know, more of the body here. There's, okay, I don't know what he actually looks like. And then maybe they want, I don't know, his arms or something like that. Or you could just build ice cream. I did this for a while too, where you just get the ice cream and you give them some ice cream every time they do a good job. You know, there's lots of different kind of anything you can think of, really. You can just add it to your Manycam, and then maybe you can see here, I can go here, and then I can add a new layer. Maybe I want to add myself eating the ice cream or something. So here I am, I'm back. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And then I can eat the ice cream. Or I could just change the layer to something else. I could change it. If you have a YouTube video, you can actually put it in here and they can watch it. Or if you have a game, a PowerPoint, anything you have, web source URL, so you can add something if you're very creative. And that is it. Or you can just remove this layer. Then we can go back in here. So that's it. Another thing you can do is play games. Sometimes they draw excessively on the screen. If you have a group, they can go crazy, and then you have to, this is a way of stopping them from drawing all over the place on the screen. Maybe you want them, so you can control this on your camera so they can't actually draw and they have to tell you. For example, these are different sports, so they have to tell you the name of the sport in order to get an X or an O in tic-tac-toe. You can just move this here like this and then do it like that. Or maybe they have to make a sentence, or you could use it to practice a grammar structure, and they absolutely love this game. Especially like kids absolutely love this game. So this is nice that you can do if you have free time at the end of class. I play a lot of games. I usually play a game at the end of class. If the class is 45 minutes or an hour, I definitely add games, because that can be a long time for students. Then you can also add text. So maybe you just want to say, you know, well done. You can add the text here. Here you can say, well done. I cannot see the text, so I have to click this button. And here we can move it. We can change the style. And we can make it bigger. Wow, cannot see it. There it is. So you can do something like that. And also, if your students are always late for class and you don't want to be caught, you really want to eat something. I always want to eat something or drink something. This is me, or use my phone. Then you can have this extra slide, and you can maybe you want to put something in it, maybe hello or welcome or something. And just when you're waiting for them to come to class and then they can't see you, and then when they come, you can transition back to the other preset, and you're here. So it's very, very easy to do. There's so many uses for Manycam, and you keep learning. You can really do just so many different things. There's a timer here, so you can set a timer if you want to have some little competition. This is 2 hours. I'm sure you won't have class for that long, but if you want, you can change the time here to, you know, 3 minutes or 1 minute if you want them to talk about a topic for that period of time, or you have a stopwatch, how long it takes them to do something maybe, and see if they can beat that time next time. And then even a clock, that's so funny. So yeah, there's all of these different things. I'm just looking at this now and just discovering things that I've never really used. But okay, so here, you can have this if you are a TV presenter, I don't know. And oh yeah, so I made some recordings on my Manycam, and then they go in the recordings section. Oh yes, also I just have the standard lifetime, so you can also use the studio version if you want, and that means that you can change your background to whatever you want. You also have access to more of these presets at the bottom. This is good, I actually think. it's good. The reason I didn't avail, I can actually upgrade to the studio. The reason I didn't avail is because I wasn't keen on the virtual backgrounds, because I don't have a green screen, and it's best to use a green screen, and then it looks really professional. You have a green screen, you can put any background you want. You can put a classroom, you can put something funny, anything you want. Maybe it's based on the topic you're learning that day. It can be really fun, and you can also have more presets. So if you're using more of them, if you want to have more than four, you can create a hello slide. You could create like a whole hello preset, a goodbye preset. There's so many different ones you can actually create if you want. But I plan to travel a lot, and then, you know, the green screen, I can't use that, because I can't really bring, it's not really travel friendly. I guess it could be, I'm not sure. It just seems rather big. So yeah, I just found that this was enough for me, and I've been using it religiously for every class. And it does take some time to get used to. I always search for everything. I never try to find things organized by category. I always just search whatever I'm looking for that day, so that I can find it really quickly. And I'm really fast at typing, so I can find everything in class. I don't even need to prepare beforehand. Sometimes I will add some extra images that I don't have to explain a topic. So that is essentially what I do. I hope you found this video helpful, and that you gained something from this Manycam online teaching tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and comment, let me know. And also, don't forget to subscribe if you want to hear more about teaching English online or starting your online teaching business. I have Manycam linked below, so you can sign up for Manycam and get started for free. They have a free version. You just have the little watermark at the side, but it's good enough for you to really gain some practice and see. And also, they have a lot of sales on. Manycam have a lot of sales, so you're likely to catch it in a sale, and it's really good value. So I highly recommend it. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you again soon.